Welcome to New Day Cleveland. I'm David Moss, and guess what? It's Pork Tenderloin Day. That's right, we're gonna cook on the big green egg. And I was thinking about ribs. Ribs are fun, they're cool, but they take a long time to cook. Pork chops, they're great, but a lot of times you cook them a little too much and they're tough. So I was looking for something tender. How about tenderloin, pork tenderloin? So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna make it a simple way so it's easy to do a couple different ways. And what I do is, like, for one way to do it, I get just some teriyaki sauce. You buy it in a store, any kind you want. You just put a little sauce in there. And we're gonna paint up one of these babies with that. And we're gonna throw in a clove of garlic. We're gonna throw in onion. That's like a slice of onion, just chopped up a little bit so it's really easy. And then we're gonna stir that up a little bit. Okay, so that's what we're gonna paint one of these pork tenderloins with. Now, these pork tenderloins cook pretty fast, 10 minutes a side. You cook them at about 350 degrees. It's easy to do. And when you first get them, take a look at them, make sure there's not a whole bunch of that silver skin on them. These are really nice and clean. You don't have to worry about this fat here because that's gonna cook and make it a little crispy, add a little fat to it because there's not a lot of fat in them. Same way with that. So we're gonna make one way and one another. So here's what we'll do. Get a little salt and pepper on this. Salt. Pepper. And then we're gonna paint it. 375 degrees, 370 degrees, anywhere between 350. Okay, so there's one. I'm gonna open up the big green egg. Over direct heat, that means just over straight charcoals. Ooh, I love that sound. I'm gonna put that in there like that. Okay, now we're gonna do one another way. So when I went to Lighthouse Pools and Spas and looked at their big green eggs, they've got a whole bunch of different sizes. And since I have a bunch of kids that hang out here, I went for an extra large one, and it's working out great, but they come in all different sizes. So when you go to Lighthouse Pools and Spas, just check out the kind. It's gonna fit your lifestyle the best. Okay, we start again with the salt and pepper. Just a little bit on this one, because this one we're gonna use some different spices. We're gonna do something really, I think it's sort of interesting. Put a little mustard on it. It's gonna make all of our dry rubs stick to the pork a whole lot nicer than it would have otherwise. Okay, any kind of dry rub you like, right? I like this Willingham's. I'm gonna put that on there. I'm not afraid to use it too, you see that? These babies are gonna ride 10 minutes aside in the big green egg. Well, it's just been under 10 minutes aside, so I think it's a good time to check the temperature. So look how beautiful this looks. This is the one that had the teriyaki sauce on it. So what we're going for is 140 degrees, because we want it to be about 145 when it's all said and done. Okay, we'll check this one. That one was good. So this one's coming down just a little bit. So we're gonna cook this one a little bit more. I'm gonna put this one back in for a couple minutes. This is the one that Natalie's gonna get a chance to taste. We're gonna slice this open. But the key is, remember, you don't slice something open until it rests for at least 5 minutes.
Well, how about that?
Looks delicious.
How do you do today?
So you let it rest for 5 minutes, let it kind of cook a little bit more.
Yeah, what happens is, you know, it's sort of like when you cook meat, you notice it always swells up a little bit. So you have to let it cool down a little bit so all the juices go back to where it came from. Otherwise, the juices are so expanded in it, wherever you put a cut in it, comes flying out.
Oh, we don't want that to happen.
Yeah, and okay. That's the same reason you don't turn stuff over with a fork. You turn over the fork, you let the juices come out, and they go like, gee, it's not as juicy as it should be. Hopefully this will be juicy. It's in the oven right now, rewarming at about, I don't know, let's see. Oh, I got it hidden in there. Let's see if I can pull it out, take a look at it.
I smell it already.
So this is what it looks like now here at the real home, New Day Cleveland. I'm gonna put it back in there just to keep it a little warm. And we're gonna make some beans. We're gonna make a bean side dish. So I got those, you know what haricot vert are?
No. Nope.
Those little tiny skinny green beans.
Oh, I know what they look like now that you say that.
Yeah, I'm gonna throw a couple down there so you can take a look at them. I'm gonna drop these in and we're gonna put all these beans in here. We're gonna put green ones. You can put regular green garden beans in here if you want. Boiling water, salted water. Let's put a little salt in there. I put some salt in there before, I'll just show you. So that's about how much salt you need. And we're also gonna put in yellow beans. Like some people call them wax beans,
wax
right?
Beans, okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we got that going and that's gonna cook for 3 minutes. So I'm gonna turn my phone on here.
I love a good bean salad.
Yeah, me too.
You gonna time it?
Yeah, I want to. My phone lets me.
Snow
there
peas
we go.
Too?
Okay, yeah, so here's what we're gonna do with this. We're gonna make a dressing. So let's make a dressing together. Okay. So I got a half a cup of buttermilk in there. Why don't you throw, we got cayenne in there. Just throw the cayenne in there. Yeah, give it a good toss. So you don't have to use the cayenne, but I like it gives it a little sparky spice. We have a half a teaspoon of onion powder we're gonna put in there.
Onion powder, okay, going in.
Oh, that's a little sticky, huh? Yeah, just give it a good hit.
Sorry, I just... Don't know, break something.
That's good enough. Okay, that's good.
Are you sure?
There's no,
okay.
Let me see that little rascal.
I was going to do that, but then I felt bad.
You'd have a garlicky
I felt bad. I did
manicure.
Wash my hands, though, before I came. Now, what's this?
That's onion powder. One's garlic powder.
Half
a teaspoon
of
each. Yeah, let's do that.
It's the humidity in here.
See, it messes with more than just your hair.
I know. Hair days.
It's a bad garlic powder day because it's humid out there. Okay, we're going to put a little salt in there. How about that? And we'll put a little pepper in, too. And we're going to put in about a tablespoon and a half of olivine olive oil, the good stuff. That's about one.
This looks good.
That's about a half. Okay, I like that. And we had a half a cup of buttermilk in there. I'm gonna take that.
Shake it.
We're gonna make sure this is on because we don't want to ruin the rest of your day.
Shake it,
baby. Put your finger in there, give it a little shake, shake, shake.
That would not be good.
No, that wouldn't be good at all. Okay, how close are we on the beans here?
Oh, thank you for that nice tight shot.
Was that good? They like
all
it.
Right.
They like it when you shake a little bit. I think it's
good.
There
we go. That looks delicious.
That looks good. Okay, so we're gonna put some other stuff in here. So here's some other stuff we're gonna put in. We're gonna put in these sugar snap peas. We're gonna do these raw. You wanna try one raw?
Oh, yeah, I love beans.
They're really good. Then I got those, what are they called, edamame beans?
Mm.
They're good, aren't they?
They're very sweet.
That's why I got them. They're really good. Then we got some edamame beans right
here.
I
love edamame.
So I peeled those. Those are already cooked, so they have to be cooked. We've got about a tablespoon of shallot. I put a little red pepper together in here, like just like crispy red pepper. Do you like that raw, too?
Love it. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then we have some pecans that I toasted a little bit. And then we're going to use a little bit of mint. And in the recipe, I say use one sprig, like, so you get that one like this. What we're going to do is we're going to use this bowl.
Okay.
And we're going to start putting stuff in here. But like this mint thing, what we're going to do is we're just going to tear off some pieces like this. So I want you to just tear it up. So you just want sort of a rough tear on it. And you don't want a lot of mint because a lot of mint is like sort of not so good.
It smells so good though.
Okay. Oh, it does smell good. Doesn't it? You smell all the way over here.
Right away.
Okay, so we're down to 22 seconds. So we're just cooking these for 3 minutes. If you want the beans a little more tender, you can cook them 4 minutes or 5 minutes. But I think we got everything that's sort of crisp. Let's keep it crisp. We don't want no limp beans in this salad. Mm-mm.
There we go.
And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna put them in an ice bath. So what I did was, I've got some ice cubes under here in this water. Oh,
there it is.
There it is.
3 minutes.
Okay, go to sleep. Okay, now. So I'm gonna put the beans in the ice water, and that sort of shocks them, stops them from cooking, and it keeps them a nice color. If you don't do this in the ice bath, you'll end up with gray looking beans.
That is an interesting little tip.
Yeah, and it won't be pretty. And also, I salted the ice water a little bit too, so when the beans come out, they're gonna have just a little bit of a salty touch. Okay, we'll let that go for a little bit. And since we have a sink here, what we're gonna do here, we don't have a sink here, is what I really meant, right? We're gonna take that, we're gonna put that here.
Drain them out.
Okay, now what you can do is just move this over here and you just start throwing everything you see in here in there.
Okay, that's
it. Toss it around a little bit. I'm gonna go get the pork.
Rogue veggies.
How are we doing?
Oh, I just tossed a few to the side.
Oh, you
did? They didn't look good, so.
You sent them away. Oh, that's good.
It was an accident, but.
Okay.
Okay.
Put that in there. We're gonna throw the pecans in there. And you've got a forky thing here, and you can put, a little bit of this, not a whole lot. Oh, you know what? We need a little lemon in there, too.
Okay, where did it go? Do you have it? Okay.
We'll just put the lemon right on here. There you go.
Now you want me to add the dressing or this one?
I would go this one. Dressing, this is just an ingredient. So we're going to put in like not all of it, but some of it. You know how to put dressing on, right? Right. Perfectly good.
I like a lot of dressing though.
And then I have the pleasure of
Oh man, I'm going to start splashing.
Yeah,
here we go. Let's do it this way.
Now you see the color of this pork here while she's doing that. You see it's like, it's just under pink, just under rosy. So that means it's not going to be dried out. So like when I talk about making those pork chops, sometimes you make pork chops and you have what, petrified pork chops? Not so good. So there, that's what that looks like.
Right. What do you think? Do I need more dressing or is that good?
It looks beautiful. Maybe
I should make it maybe, look a little bit more presentable.
Maybe a little sprinkle of salt and pepper on it.
Okay.
You know what? We could open a catering company if we talk to like our personal chefs and all that kind of stuff.
I think we would make a great team.
Well, we make a terrific team. Doesn't matter what we're doing, okay. Right? Okay, what are we gonna do here? We're gonna put some salad on this plate now. So let me have, you can use that, you can keep that. I'll take this.
Okay, you do that, okay.
Go like this. Some here.
Oh, that looks so good.
This is terrible, isn't it? I've got a plate.
That is a great
plate. I've got a plate right down there if you want to grab it, that white plate.
See how that flies? Dressing. Did you bring one for yourself too, just in case you wanted to try it?
That's what I always do, you know. Last time I tried to take a fork from you, I almost got hurt. You reached over.
It's true.
And I had halfway to my choppers and it was gone. How's that little salad doing?
That dressing is unbelievable. And you can taste the mint. It's great. It gives it that little added touch.
Okay, now we're gonna set this
up. The beans are cooked perfectly.
Well, I think you should try this.
Okay.
That's gonna be terrible, you can tell.
I can tell but look at how easily that cuts.
So Tom, who's running the camera right now, was there when we cooked this, and we were worried about, like, what's it gonna be like if I put it away and then reheat it? What do you think, Tom? How'd it work out?
Looks good.
Looks good.
It is juicy.
We're in the ballpark here.
That's good stuff.
Mm-hmm. So that's how you do
it. That's great.
Okay.
It's so juicy too.
So you put that out, you get a little bit of sauce here. You know what I did? I made a little tiny teriyaki sauce too.
Dab it on there. Thank you. That's a great added touch.
There you go. So the recipe's online, it's easy. And a lot of it is you just make it up as you go and you really can't mess it up. Just as long as you stay awake while you're doing it, you should be okay.
That's a great dressing, I'll tell you. That is awesome to put on probably a lot of different veggies.
Yeah, and that was the thing too. Almost anything you find in the refrigerator, if it's like a teriyaki sauce or one of those ginger sauces or any of those Japanese sauces are terrific, or if you just want to use Italian dressing, even something like that. But it all works out pretty good. This one almost got away, but it didn't.
Well, there you go, there's your piece. You didn't even need the fork after all.
You know what we're missing here?
What?
Cocktails.
Oh,
they only
yes,
come after the
of
break.
Course.
They're called shrubs. I'm gonna show you two ways to make them. I'm talking with my mouth full.